religions or any kind of lineages at all, there was this.
Having all sorts of
escaping from the this discomfort that might be.
I never asked.
You know,
Hi, I'm Alex Howard, and welcome to Conscious 2, and welcome to Something from Nothing, a 3-hour live stream with Stuart Davis. Over the next 3 hours, we're going to be exploring how you can birth your creative vision into the world. We'll be going into some teaching, some practical exercises, and also some interaction and discussion. And if you guys at home want to be part of this, the best way to do so is you'll see below this video, there's a comment section. And you can post questions and comments and sharings in there. In the last 30 minutes or so of today's event, I'll put some of those questions to Stuart. When we're watching things on the internet, it's very easy to sit there and just passively watch something and disappear onto Facebook and Twitter and whatever else. And at Conscious 2, we really try to encourage you to be as though you were here in the room with us, to really have the experience you would have if you were part of this workshop. We really try to capture the intimacy and transmission of an in-person event. But we can only do that if you give us your full attention. And of course, if you were here, hopefully you wouldn't be going off onto Facebook, Twitter, or whatever else. The only time we allow you to go to Facebook and Twitter is if you are tweeting or sharing what's happening in the event. We're also going to be talking towards the end of today's event about a 6-month online course with Stuart, where he's going to be diving a lot deeper into these ideas. And in the email you probably received just now, sending you the details of how to join us, there's also further information in there as well. So I firstly also want to welcome our in-person audience. Thank you guys for being here. In a sense, you guys are the voices of people at home, so no pressure whatsoever. And I want to welcome Stuart.
How are you, brother?
I'm really good. At this point, I normally say, so-and-so is, and I give like a short kind of introduction. But it's not very easy to do with you, Stuart. And I just want to say at the top as well, before we come into kind of you and your background, that I've met a lot of people over the last few years of Conscious 2. I've done a lot of interviews, a lot of these kind of live stream events. And people often say to me, friends often say to me, you know, so who have you met that's like really kind of surprised you? And for the last few months, I've been saying, since we met at Ken Wilber's Loft, we did an event there back in October, I've been saying, Stuart Davis, he's totally awesome. And not just awesome from the point of view of being an artist musician we'll come into, but I'm also incredibly excited seeing you coming forward as a teacher of this side as well. So I just want to say I really appreciate you being here. It's been a real treat just hanging out the last few days, and you're just a very, very cool person, I think. Not that I'm...
Thank you very much for the kind words. I think you've made the perilous mistake of inviting a musician into your home and into your local community, and the danger is always that they will never leave.
This is right. I have to say, my wife did say, you know, is he going to be completely wild or completely crazy? She's also loved having you here, so thank you, buddy.
It is, it's all of that. I mean, there's a lot of wildness and craziness and all of that. There's certainly, it's not just persona. I love to, security, intruder, talk about wild and crazy people. The wildness and the craziness is authentic and genuine then, but also I feel privileged and excited to be participating in this with you and to take up a new role and position in what it is to engage in a creative endeavor. Mm. So it's a new experience for me to go over the threshold from purely the artistic side, purely the creative side, to getting to participate in the great privilege, which is really, I think, one of the great miracles of existence, is people creating something from nothing. Our entire course is this community, this gathering, this tribe of folks focused around bringing something into fruition that's truly important and valuable to them. And I truly feel that is a huge privilege. So I'm really excited to be here.
So as I was saying at the start, it's often, for you particularly, it's difficult to say, well, who is Stuart Davis? Because not only are you a musician, a singer-songwriter, you've also produced TV series. So how do you define yourself as a starting point?
Well, maybe one way would be like a human collage. You know, there's one of the great benefits and gifts of engaging on a spiritual path, and especially an integral spiritual path and artistic endeavors, is that the range of options and possibilities is so vast and so deep that I think the central
challenge of my life is narrowing it down to the few that I can truly engage deeply with. So it is an embarrassment of riches in the sense of all the things, especially in today's day and age with the internet and what has become a global community. The passion that I feel for music is duplicated in the passion that I feel for making television and writing films. I paint, I do comedy, and they're all uniquely wonderful and singular in their own ways. And every time I've taken up a new medium, it's certainly not that I've mastered each of them. It's certainly not that I feel like I have a command of each one of those mediums. But what definitely happens is that a new dimension of myself is activated. Mm. And then I find whole new muscles and realms of exploration that can really, it's kind of like an interior or inward cosmology. It's like being an inward astronaut, and you get to explore all of these interior vast landscapes. It's like going to exoplanets or different worlds, but it's all within the self, and it's all immediately available. So how I would describe myself, I think previously when we talked, I said that I was an aspiring human. Mm. I think that is still an accurate description. It contains all of the artistic endeavors. It also includes my spiritual practices. I have a long relationship with Zen and other contemplative disciplines, contemplative
Christianity. Have we got a mic issue? Yeah. I mean, if you tell Nick, we'll put him on the other hand. So we just have a slight... But this one here is probably better. Can you come and mic Stuart up?
You bet.
Just swap them over, yeah. Gotcha. This is the beauty of live broadcast. For those people that maybe are thinking, this is another one of those pre-recorded webinars that people do. I'm on a headset mic here, so I'm good.
There we go. I'm going to put this one in my pocket and actually
just take it, take it home. Shoplift it.
Shoplift this, take it home for the little souvenir. So did they get much of that, or should I repeat my answer?
They got it.
They did, okay.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, I think the short answer is aspiring human, and that includes all of the creative endeavors and the spiritual ones. And frankly, as we get a little bit more into the story, I also think that they're nearly synonymous. You know, the deeper that you get into the creative realms and disciplines, the more that you find the overlay and compatibility, and they really synergize each other, and we'll get to more of that in a minute. Well,
I remember you were saying to me, I think it was last night, when you first picked up a guitar, what that experience was like. Because I just want to touch a little bit on just how you came into being an artist, in a sense. Because as we talk about the creative process and people kind of birthing their own creative projects, I think it's nice people to plug into just a little bit about how that birthed inside of you. So yeah, just tell me the story. It's kind of beautiful what happened when you first played a guitar.
You know, when you look back on your life, there's these instances, and they may not be great in number, but they're these watershed moments, really clear instances when an avalanche kind of occurs on the inside. And for me, the first one, and continuing to this day, a central one, was the day that I learned to play guitar. My dad taught me three chords on a guitar in our living room, and it was as though I had contacted physically a part of my own anatomy that I had not had access to before. Mm. When I held that guitar and I played those chords, it truly just, like tumblers on a safe door, they just dropped into place and the door swung open, and I realized, oh my gosh, this is with total certitude. I think I was 11 years old. I knew day one that I was going to do this for the rest of my life. I knew I had discovered something totally pivotal about my entire life story. In fact, I felt certitude that I was going to be a professional musician. I just, like, my life kind of, I had this, it wasn't a psychic event, but it was a kind of intuiting of what the rest of my life would entail to a large degree. But I didn't tell anyone, even, because I knew it would sound stupid for an 11-year-old to say, guess what? I just learned three chords and now I know I'm going to do this for the rest of my life. I'm going to be a musician.
Like, I mean, let's be honest, there are some musicians that three chords are all we've ever needed.
That's true.
But looking at your body of work, I think it's true to say you went significantly beyond three chords.
I got addicted to chords and I went and learned a bunch more. But I went into my basement day one and I played 5 to 6 hours a day. And more importantly, I began writing. Day one, the
the language of music, the vocabulary of those chords and melodies was immediately linked for me with writing songs. Mm. And they never, there was not two stages. It was just immediately I